start our today's session. I will share sound and PPT also. So dear students, we will see first derivation, Clausius-Mossetti equation. It's very simple. If you could remember two, three equations, I will give you hints. Now if you have taken notebook, just write down or just listen it, okay? I will think that you listen it first, and if any difficulties there, you can ask me, okay? So that way, let us start it. Now we are just studying properties of dielectric material. We have seen last time ferroelectric materials. Today we will see piezoelectric materials. I am going very slow, one material by one material, so that you will try to remember exact properties, because there should not be confusion, because this part is something of a little confusion. So that way I am just revising, reinforcing topics again and again with videos also. So first see our equation derivation, and then we will go to the piezoelectric material. So now Clausius-Mossetti equation. Clausius-Mossetti is the scientist's name. So he had just given this equation related to the polarization. So we have seen definitions and simple equations related to polarization and electric flux density D and permittivity. So now Clausius-Mossetti equation to derive, you have to write or you have to consider some assumptions. And 99% students forget writing assumptions while deriving it in the university or any exam. So I will tell you, don't forget to write down assumptions, because equation is with some assumptions, and 2 marks will be always there for assumptions. So if you see derivation is asked for 8 marks, assumptions will have 2 marks. So even if you will write down all steps, you may get only 6 out of 8. So what are the assumptions? So first assumption is, if you see, the polarizability of molecule is isotropic. So now we know what is polarizability. Name only implies it is the ability of material to get polarization. So if we are finding equation for polarization, so we have to find out what is polarizability of the material. So polarizability of molecule is isotropic. So you know the nature, isotropic means how many molecules will be there, how they will arrange, because dipole moments depends upon number of molecules in the material also, and their arrangement also, because we have seen when it is a rare gas, then in rare gas molecule, atom to atom distance is large and interaction between neighboring atom is zero, and therefore it's very simple type of polarization occurs there. Electronic polarization occurs, but when molecule will be ionic, then positive and negative, and that will be ionic polarization. So in this derivation, it is assumed that it is isotropic. The arrangement of molecule is also isotropic. Polarizability is also isotropic. Arrangement of molecule is also isotropic. In short, atom to atom distance is large, and then you can say polarization of molecule is by elastic displacement only. Now, what is that elastic displacement? It is nothing but electronic polarization. Means center of negative charge of the revolving electron and center of positive ion will get displaced. So just another word is used instead of electronic polarization, elastic displacement. So that is the displacement between the center of positive charge and center of revolving electrons. And then fourth assumption is absence of short range interaction. So absence of short range interactions means non-dipolar, means other polarization you will forget it, okay? So all these assumption conditions are fulfilled by rare gases. I already told, so it is just derivation is for rare gases, okay? So total polarization by elemental solid dielectrics is given by, we have seen equation, okay? So what that equation we have seen, polarization is equal to N alpha E into E I. So what is this N? I already told you, polarization is proportional to the number of molecules in the material and also electric field intensity. Now what is E I? EI is what is internal electric field intensity, because generally we use E means external field. When we apply some voltage across the electrode, then polarization happens between the material. But here intensity inside the material we have to consider. There will be difference between external electric applied field and internal electric field. So polarizability, it is a constant of proportionality, because polarization is proportional to number of molecules and also internal electric field intensity. And constant of proportionality is polarizability. Now, why E suffix is written? Electronic polarizability, because I told you when it is ionic polarization, it will be alpha I or it will be alpha O. So when alpha O will be there, it will be orientational polarization. Now, as we are considering rare gases, our polarizability will be only electrostatic displacement. So alpha is written. So this equation, you remember, I have written these equations which you have to remember in yellow color. So if you will remember equations written in yellow color, that is just only simplified equation. Derivation is very simple. Simplifications. If you could remember three equations, okay. So that way you just remember how we can just simplify it. Now, so where P is total polarization, is number of atoms per unit volume, because we are considering P is polarization is the number of dipole moments created per unit volume. So this N is also per unit volume. Alpha is electronic polarizability. Alpha I is Lorentz internal field, because that is Lorentz force. Lorentz force is created, again scientist name. Therefore, field produced is also known as Lorentz internal field. Now the Lorentz internal field is given by, again you remember this second equation. So yellow colored equations you have to remember for the derivation. So what Lorentz says? Lorentz says that internal electric field intensity will be external electric field intensity plus polarization. I told you in last two lectures before this. Because when polarization occurs, without polarization, whatever will be internal electric field intensity, that will be equal to external. This will be zero because polarization is not there. But if polarization will start happening inside the material, definitely electric flux density or intensity will increase, and this will be P upon thrice epsilon zero. Okay, so remember this equation. Lorentz internal field EI is given by external field plus P polarization upon thrice epsilon zero. So it is the permittivity of free space. Because you have to consider in free space what was there, and then what happens when that material is replaced by some, vacuum is replaced by some material. Now substitute this value of EI in equation 1. So just put this E plus P upon thrice epsilon. Yes. Any doubt is there?
Screen is not visible.
Screen is not visible? All students?
Visible, ma'am.
Visible,
ma'am.
Visible. So, who says no?
Visible.
Who says,
visible.
1 minute. Who says no? Just stop it. Who says no? Just click from your mobile and go to the screen. Okay. Now substitute value of EI in equation 1. Okay. Now if you will substitute this, so equation will be N alpha E instead of EI, it will be E plus P upon thrice epsilon 0. Very simple. Okay. So just remember how you can proceed to the equation. Now second equation, another equation, I have discussed it in last lecture. Flux density D will be equal to epsilon 0 E plus P. So this is due to the free space, and this is due to when you will replace that free space by material, polarization will be there. Okay. So therefore D is equal to epsilon 0 E plus P. Now where D is electric flux density. So now just you can see, divide this equation by E. Okay, write down there in your notebook, you write down dividing this equation by E. So what you will get it? Now see here, P upon E will be P upon E. This epsilon 0 E upon E, E will get cancelled, epsilon 0. So that will be epsilon 0, and it will be D upon E. So D upon E, because you are dividing this equation, and this you are writing P is equal to. So this term, when it will go to left hand side, it will be minus. Okay. So P upon E is equal to D upon E minus epsilon 0. You read from the notes. If you will not understand, you can ask me again. Okay. Now also we know that what is electric flux density? It is permittivity into intensity. That also we know. This is the very basic formula. D is equal to epsilon E. Now putting value of D in above equation. So put this D means epsilon E. Just simple putting and just simplifying it. So P upon E will be equal to, now instead of this D, it will be epsilon E. So epsilon E upon E, other equation remains same. Now again this E and E will get cancelled. So it will be epsilon minus epsilon 0. Okay. Now see, so that will be, you can see it is epsilon minus epsilon 0. Now what is epsilon? Epsilon also, you know, epsilon is equal to epsilon 0. Epsilon R, otherwise if you remember, epsilon R is equal to epsilon upon epsilon 0. Then you can see epsilon will be equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon R. So just put this value. Permittivity will be equal to absolute permittivity into relative permittivity. So epsilon 0 into epsilon R, just simple putting values and just simplifying it. Now again take epsilon 0 common from this. So P upon E will be equal to epsilon 0 you had taken common, and it will be epsilon R from this, and here it will be minus 1. So it will be this equation. So now what will be polarization? Polarization will be equal to E will come to the right hand side. So E epsilon 0 epsilon R minus 1. This equation also we have seen, I think. I told you. Now substitute value of this P. So whatever you have obtained this P, you have to substitute value in the equation 2. So what is equation 2? Just see this equation. So here we have found out polarization. Now you substitute value of P into this equation. So that will be equal to N alpha E. You remember this, what is there, okay. So if you substitute value, you will get such a long equation, but it is just simply, you have to simplify it. So see, substituting value of P. So this is the value of P. And this is again same from equation 2. Now take E common. It will get cancelled. So you take E common. Here it is E. And actually you can see here it is E. Here it is E. So from this rectangle, you take E common. So it will be N alpha E into E. And when it is N alpha E into E, right hand side E and left hand side E will get cancelled. So your equation will be only epsilon 0 epsilon R minus 1 will be equal to N alpha E, because E had cancelled out, and as you had taken E, it will remain only 1. Here it E will not be there. So epsilon 0 epsilon R minus 1 upon thrice epsilon 0. Now again this epsilon 0 will get cancelled. Okay, so it will be N alpha E 1 plus. So it will be 1 plus epsilon r minus 1 divided by 3. Again, you take LCM 3. So if you multiply this 3 here, it will be 3. So it will be 3. And again, it will be remain same, because LCM is 3 and it is having denominator 3. So this term will remain same, epsilon r minus 1 divided by 3. Okay, so this term will get simplified into this. So now you can say N alpha E, you just find out N alpha E will be equal to epsilon 0 epsilon R minus 1, and this term you are taking to this side, okay. So N alpha E will be equal to epsilon 0 epsilon R minus 1 divided by this, okay. Now again you will just see that N alpha E will be equal to thrice, because you can just see it will be thrice epsilon 0. You just see here what will happen. It will be epsilon R 3 minus 2. So it will be epsilon R plus 2. Okay. So that division epsilon R plus 2 from this bracket. 3, 3 will get cancelled. Not cancelled, because 3 minus 1 will be 2. So epsilon R plus 2 will be in the denominator. And this will be thrice epsilon 0 epsilon R minus 1. So now again this thrice epsilon 0 is a constant, because absolute permittivity is a constant, and for any material alpha E polarizability is also constant, number of dipole number of molecules per unit volume is constant. So take constants at left hand side. So it will be N alpha E upon thrice epsilon 0 will be equal to epsilon R minus 1 plus divided by epsilon R plus 2. So remember this equation. This is known as Clausius Mossetti relation. So remember this equation. So what it indicates? It indicates that, see, now this constant, it is related to polarization. So polarizability, in short, you can say that polarizability is dependent upon relative permittivity. So relative permittivity minus 1 divided by relative permittivity plus 2. But not only polarizability, but that is n upon thrice epsilon 0 is also there. Means permittivity of free space is there, permittivity of material is there, and you know what is alpha e, means it is electronic polarizability. So you consider any dielectric material, the material to which it will get polarized, it depends upon relative permittivity. That is the meaning of the Clausius-Mossetti equations. Now we will see a polar piezoelectric material. Okay, last time we have seen types of polarization, ferroelectric materials. So can you tell me, students, what do you mean by ferroelectric material? Yes. What is ferroelectric material? So when you will get spontaneous polarization. So what is spontaneous polarization? Term spontaneous polarization. It is, you can say, some materials, even if electric field you will not apply, in absence of electric field also, it will have some polarization. So electric field, applied electric field is zero, but still it has some polarization. Such materials are known as ferroelectric materials, and they exhibit hysteresis loop. When you will go on changing, when you will apply sine wave, AC supply, then polarization will go on changing, and we have seen initially polarization will increase, but when you will start reducing electric field, it will not take the same path, it will take another path, so it will lag. So polarization will lag behind electric field. So this is a lagging. Why it is lagging? See, electric field has become zero, but still polarization will not be zero. So that is why it is known as hysteresis. Hysteresis means lagging behind. Who is lagging behind whom? Polarization is lagging behind electric field. Okay. And then if you want to have zero polarization, you have to apply intensity in reverse direction. So this much intensity you have to apply to make polarization zero. So that is known as coercive field. Okay. And you can see here, EC is coercive fold, field, and then BR is remanent polarization. So that was the just revision. So properties we discussed, I show you the video on ferroelectric materials applications. Now let us see piezoelectric materials. Now what is piezoelectric material? You know that piezoelectric materials are used in gas lighters. Okay, so last time I tried to show you video also little bit, because you should not confuse again between ferroelectric material and the piezoelectric material, because we have to see pyroelectric materials also. So piezoelectric material, this effect was discovered by scientists Jacques and Pierre Curie. So both scientists observed this effect in 1880. Okay. And they found that if certain crystals were subjected to mechanical strain, they become electrically polarized. And the degree of polarization was proportional to applied strain. So you just imagine that you are stretching rubber. To understand this, you just imagine you stretch the rubber, you apply stress or you apply strain. And when you are stretching rubber, you know that molecule or atoms or rubber also get stretched. So now you have just come to know what is polarization. So by stretching means you can say whatever charges are there in that material, you are stretching, means you are splitting that charges. So what will happen if the charges are splitted? Then dipole moments will be created, and when dipole moments will be created, polarization will be there. Means electric field will be produced, because charges are separated, means voltage will be also produced there. So whenever you will apply strain, it will produce electricity. So this effect means apply force produce electricity, that is piezoelectricity. And what will be principle of operation of piezoelectric devices or piezoelectric generator? So principle of operation will be piezoelectric effect is the production of electricity by pressure. So apply physical pressure, produce electricity. That will not happen to all materials. that will happen to particular materials, quartz. You know the quartz crystal. So very dielectric crystal is subjected to mechanical strain. It produces an electrostatic charge on the faces of the crystal. So two faces are there, means two sides are there. So across the two sides, two different charge will get displaced, and this phenomenon is known as piezoelectricity. Okay, so remember this. So here it is tension and here it is compression. So you compress the material. So if you compress the material, distance between the charges will get reduced. So you can say polarization will be reduced. But when you will apply the tension, means stretch it, then you will see these charges you are stretching. And if charges are displaced, this is nothing but dipole moment. And therefore you can get electricity, means potential difference between this positive and negative. So you just see voltage will be created. Okay. Now you just change the direction of your pressure, you will observe reverse effect. Okay. So that is about the piezoelectric. Now watch this video.
Piezoelectricity. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to explain piezoelectric effect, discuss the applications of piezoelectricity.
Sound is coming or no?
As a morning routine, walks up to the kitchen to make a hot cup of coffee. As she gas stove,
yes ma'am, coming.
Struck by previous thought. How come a simple click of a gas lighter result in a sparking fire? What could be the principle behind it? Well, the gas lighter ignites using the principle of piezoelectricity. Piezoelectricity is not just confined to your kitchen, but applied in diverse fields. Well, as an important element in the car's airbag sensor, triggering the safety airbag based on the intensity of shock during any mishap. Does piezoelectricity sound new to you? Sure, this lesson will help you understand better. Piezoelectricity is the property of some materials when subjected to mechanical stress generates an electrical potential across it. The generated voltage is proportional to the stress applied. This property is known as piezoelectric effect. The word piezo is derived from the Greek word pisein, which means squeeze or press. The piezoelectric effect was discovered by French brothers Pierre Curie and Jacques Curie in the year 1880. They used quartz and Rochelle salt for demonstration, which naturally exhibits the piezoelectric effect. Other such materials are topaz, tourmaline, and cane sugar. The crystals which exhibit piezoelectric effect are known as piezoelectric crystals. Piezoelectric materials such as lead zirconate titanate, barium titanate, potassium niobate can be grown artificially. One of the unique features of the piezoelectric materials is the inverse piezoelectric effect occurring in the opposite way of direct effect. When voltage is applied across piezoelectric materials, they tend to vibrate and deform slightly. This effect is known as inverse piezoelectric effect. Next, we shall understand the concept of piezoelectric effect. Piezoelectricity results from the electric dipole moment of the crystal. Usually, the domains containing electric dipoles aligned in same direction are randomly oriented in the crystal so that net polarization of the crystal is zero and maintains symmetry. For net polarization to develop, the dipole formed must not be cancelled out by other dipoles in the crystal. When mechanical stress is applied to the crystal, the domains get disturbed and are aligned in a particular direction. This causes the distribution of charges on the crystal faces, which results in the generation of the electric voltage across the crystal. This effect is known as piezoelectricity. Once, if the domains are displaced, they do not return back to the original position. Piezoelectricity finds useful applications such as the detection of sound, generation of high voltages, and electronic frequency generation. Piezoelectric effect is applied in quartz watches, which use the piezoelectric quartz crystal. The movement of the watch depends mainly on the small piece of quartz crystal. The crystal is in the shape of tiny tuning fork, which vibrates 32,768 times per second. The battery electrifies the quartz crystal so that it begins to vibrate. A microchip detects the number of vibrations and turns them into fixed number of electric pulses. The electric pulses drive the stepping motor, and mechanical movement of the motor turns the cogs, which rotate the hands of the clock to show the time. This piezoelectric effect of quartz allow for incredibly accurate measurement. Piezoelectricity made history during the breakout of World War I with the introduction of practical application for piezoelectric devices in the warships called as sonar, which was used by warships to detect submarines. Another interesting application is the cigarette lighter. Pressing the button causes a spring-loaded hammer to hit a piezoelectric crystal. This produces sufficiently high voltage, due to which an electric current flows through a small spark gap, thus heating and igniting the gas. The piezoelectric effect plays a vital role in energy harvesting, as it is a potent source of renewable energy. Piezoelectric generating sidewalk is a modern technology to improve energy efficiency. Piezoelectric crystal arrays are placed underneath pavements and sidewalks. The charging pads under the crosswalk collect energy.
Ma'am, sound is not coming.
Devices. Some of the futuristic applications are robotic insects and cyborg moths, which help the humankind in any searching and rescuing during hazardous operations. Summary. This brings us to the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you have learnt about principle of piezoelectricity, concept of piezoelectric effect, the applications of piezoelectricity.
Okay, now students, I hope that you understood piezoelectricity in a more better way. You have visualized how dipole moment changes their directions, that it's type of just orientational polarization, and mainly piezoelectric materials will be used in transducers. Okay, so we'll see properties and applications. So what are first piezoelectric materials? What are the examples? So raw chili salt is there, lead zirconate is there, natural quartz is there, then ammonium dihydrogen phosphate, you can say ADP is there, lithium sulfate is there, group 2 to group 6 compounds, semiconductors, such as compounds of zinc and cadmium with OS, Se and T. So you can just say barium titanate, lead titanate. So particularly you have to remember materials for piezo, pyro and ferro also. Now what are the properties? So properties of dielectric material means mainly polarization and dielectric constant. So you have to remember dielectric constant and for spontaneous polarization. Spontaneous polarization means in absence of electric field, means the piezoelectric material also have spontaneous polarization. Now barium titanate is having dielectric constant highest, you can see. and quartz crystal is having dielectric constant very less. This value is not known. Dash means not known. Okay. So just remember these properties of dielectric material. Now applications you have watched. So what are the applications? Generally transducer. Transducer means they will convert one form of energy into another form. So okay. So they are used in transducer because you know mechanical strain is converted into electric field. Okay. And there is dimensional change also. Now, why dimensional change is happening? Because you are applying mechanical strain. And as dimensional change, mechanical displacements is happening, it will produce electric field. So they are using air transducers like earphones. So what happens in earphone? You have seen it. When suppose I am just talking it. So when I am talking, my sound waves will be converted into pressure. And that pressure will be converted into electricity. Because when I'm talking it, due to my waves, some pressure waves will be created by transducer and then it will be converted into electricity. So that will be amplified and then person can hear it. Earphones, microphones, hearing aids, then high voltage generators, because spark can be created. You have just seen it in the gas lighter. Okay, so high voltage generators like the ones in gas lighters, spark plugs, impact fuses, flash bulb actuators. Bulb actuators also it will be used, flash bulbs. Then gramophone pickups, ultrasonic flaw detectors, ultrasonic cleaning transducers. When AC supply is given, it creates vibrations of the materials. And that vibration means nothing but the stress that will be converted into, it will induce agitations in the tank liquid. And that ultrasonic, you can say detectors, flaw means crack or some physical damage to the material, hairline cracks. So if pressure is there, if flaw is there, some another effect is there. So you can just see. Applications, resonators for frequency control. Then they are also using delay lines in communications, means to give some delay. Then destructive and non-destructive testing. Destructive testing means what? Suppose you are testing material. Suppose I am testing paper and that paper will damage, means I will see breakdown voltage of the paper. So that is destructive testing because that paper will break down and I will not use that paper again. So that is destructive testing. Non-destructive testing means I will just give high voltage and I can just see how much voltage paper can withstand. I will not increase voltage up to breakdown. Then that is called as non-destructive testing. Means I'm measuring suppose tan delta. So in measurement of tan delta, material is not disrupted. So non-destructive testing. So these materials are also used in that testing. Then it can be used for flow and level measurement. Again, transducer. So electric power can cause vibrations in transducers. So transmit sound waves. And then in compression accelerometers over a wide range of frequencies, where mechanical forces are converted into electrical response. So you can just type any device. Suppose you want to see how it happens. You can type in YouTube that flow and lever measurement using piezoelectricity. And just tick on the videos. Means even if you will just use Google search engine and you type it flow level measurement using piezoelectric, you can see pictures, you can see videos. So I will request you go on watching such a video so that your concepts will be very clear. Because right now you have much and more time and this way you can utilize for interesting because to watch the videos also it's interesting. And it will help you to understand the concepts and as well as remember applications also. So that way spend some time after I just give you my video recording of lecture. I already told you immediately after lecture on the same day you watch only that part. No, I will not tell you you watch whole lecture. You just take that slider which points you could not understand. It is called as muddy point. So where is muddy point? You can just watch it. Just try to understand it and again put in Google search, have some videos, visualization and that will make you to remember also and understand also, because material science is important from gate point of view also. And already I told you final year high voltage is based on this. So now again watch this, it is just project.
This is just a short video to show you some of the properties of a piezoelectric ceramic material. In this case, I have a sample, a small disc of piezoelectric ceramic. It's the dirty silver colored disc, and it's bonded to a brass disc. You can buy these for a very low price in many outlets. They're called piezo buzzer discs in some cases. At any rate, it's a piece of piezoelectric ceramic, very thin disc shape, bonded on one side to a piece of brass. And I'm going to connect it to a voltmeter by setting the disc on one thin brass sheet that's connected to the negative lead of the voltmeter. And I'm going to connect the upper surface of the disc through this brass rod into the positive lead of the voltmeter. What I'm going to do now is press downward on this brass disc and watch the voltmeter reading. See, it goes positive and then it swings negative as I release the pressure. So I'm going to apply pressure and then release pressure. When I apply pressure, you'll see the voltage swing positive. When I release, you'll see it swing back negative. Okay, so I'm going to apply and release. Apply and release. Apply and release. And you can see I'm getting about 2 or 3 volts with this small amount of pressure. Another aspect of the disc I'd like to illustrate is the fact that piezoelectric ceramics, and in fact all ferroelectric materials, are pyroelectric, which means that they respond to heat. If I raise the temperature, I also generate a voltage. And I'm going to do that with this hairdryer. Just to convince you that it's not the sound of the hairdryer that's doing it, I'm going to turn on the hairdryer, point it away from the disc, and then I'm going to rotate it toward the disc and watch the voltmeter as I rotate toward the disc and away from the disc. Rotating toward the disc, rotating away from the disc, toward the disc, away from the disc. So here we have a voltage produced by heating of the material. And notice that the polarity was negative. The voltage produced was negative. This is a very nice test of a ceramic material. If you don't know which direction the polarization vector is, connect a voltmeter to it, heat up the material, and if you create a positive voltage, that means that the polarization vector is in the direction that you've connected the electrodes from negative to positive. If it's negative, as in this case, it means that the polarization vector is in the opposite direction, in this case from the positive down to the negative electrode. So those are just two of the features of piezoelectric ceramics. We see the voltage produced by an applied pressure, and we see the voltage produced by a temperature change. Thank you.
So pyroelectric material we will see in next lecture. So before that, I want to tell you. Now see, I already told you, you start with activity 6. Today is activity 4, last date, mini project. But not a single student uploaded in Google Classroom. Now activity 6 can be role play or just game. Suppose now piezoelectricity, just now I had taught. So how you can think to play activity? Take gas lighter, take some your another piezoelectric materials in the house if they are available, or ferroelectric materials also. Then either you can use in the class, just ask. Suppose you are playing a role play. So in role play, you just say, I am a piezoelectric material. I do like this. I produce electricity. If you will force me, if you will press me, like that, you can have dialogues on piezoelectric materials. That is role play. Then you can show the devices. You can bring gas lighter. You can show by keeping video. By keeping camera on your hand, what you are just trying to show, or in reverse way, like this video is done, you can do video also. Whatever material you have in your house, you just say that, see, I am this, I am like that. Or if you are playing game, you just ask the questions to the audience. even if in that case you can make video, okay? Suppose gas lighter you are holding in a hand and you are taking video. What is this? Guess it. You can pause video while playing. You can pause it and let the class answer what is that material, what is the property of that material, and you can just ask them which is this material. Means I am telling you example of last year students. They played treasure hunt game in the class. So treasure hunt game, how they played? They just made the cheat to pick up for the groups. And suppose there was written this and that resistivity value. Then students ran away in the lab here and there, and they brought that material whose resistivity of was in that value, or just some not direct material they asked, some applications or characteristics, and they treasure hunt. So they tried searching, and after searching they brought in class. So who came first by bringing all that materials, they own the game. So like that, here online also you can play like that. Here nobody will bring, or if it is possible to bring from home, that way you can ask the questions. Now you have piezoelectric materials, magnetic materials, not only you have to take this unit, conducting materials, you ask some tricky questions. Let them bring it and show it, because we are just using online videos are on, cameras are on. You can just share your screen. That way control we can have for that lecture. So you think on it. Only thing how it is different than your activity 13. In activity 13, you just, many students just presented but read from the PPT. Here you just prepared it, okay? So if suppose you are playing role play, okay, you use some help of the written material from your paper, but try to say at least few dialogues, few sentences without referring. That way try to improve your confidence level, communication level. Now as it is online, no fear that you will not see persons are sitting ahead of you. So that way it's very easy. Actually, I like actually online sessions. Now see, I can show you videos, I can show you animations, but in normal lectures, everything you have to imagine, because how many times we will use PPT and LCD on, and that it takes so much time, and drawing figures also take a lot of time. So here I think speed, coverage speed is also more. So that way I just wanted to tell you about activity 6. You just think it and play it in Saturday's practical. At least 2-3 groups come ahead and use Saturday's practical slot. So tell me today, tomorrow, who will present in Saturday's practical. Come yourself. I will not put timetable, okay? So now let us see our activity, this I will just show you rubric for our activity, mini project activity. So just I will share that Google Classroom. I think you are not referring whatever is given to you. You are not referring. So can you see my Google Classroom screen, student?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now see, today is last date of activity number 4 and 66 students assigned, and in class 73 students are there. So what is remaining students? They have not joined Google Classroom yet, and turn in are 0. So this picture is making me very sad. Not a single student could upload. I will see by evening how many of you are uploading. Try to be punctual student, okay? And now just see rubric for this, okay? Just see, I'm uploading the notes, whether you are referring or no, I don't know. So unit wise I have made experimental write-ups also, I have put up. Now practical B activity is there. I have just uploaded videos. I don't know how many of you have gone through it. Now rubrics you had to refer. You are not referring rubrics for activity. So activity 4 rubrics, activity 6 rubric also, read that rubric and then plan for your activity. So just see what is activity 4 rubric. So what is this mini project? Activity 4 is mini project, and for mini project, what is the criteria? Context to the material science subject. So this is very important. What is the context to material science subject? Or you are doing anything. Okay, so context, if it is high, you will get 3 points. So context means what? Conducting material. What is in the material science? Conducting material, insulating materials, magnetic materials. So you have to use related to materials. You have to talk on that. So context, if it is high, 3 points, moderate, 2 points, and less, 1 point. Then how you are presenting? So presentation, excellent, moderate, and average means what? Here it is written. So excellent means what? What points you have covered, like specifications, design, selection. So here, if it is very simple, you are not using any design, you are not selecting, you have to talk why you selected that material. Suppose LED lamp, why you are selecting that LED lamp? You just talk from material point of view. Even if you are using cello tape for sticking, you talk on that cello tape material. So instead of design, if it is not there, you talk on material specifications, means try to tell something about that material, even if it will not have specifications. Then innovation and creativity. This I will just say, this presentation means simply related to material science. Are you talking about the properties of material? Are you talking proper actual applications of that material? Suppose LED lamp you are using, you just say what is the importance of LED lamp, why it is used nowadays, what are the characteristics of that, what is power consumption, any characteristics you add it. So have technical presentation. Okay, you are telling procedure. I have taken this, I have taken that. Okay, that is also there, but you have to talk technical aspects of that also. So here, 3 points are there. Presentation and your material selections and context, this is also 3 points. And then innovation and creativity. It is the most important. 4 points are there for your innovative and creative ideas. So what is your idea of the project? Means apan mhanto na khup chhan jala project, tar ithe 4 mark thevle. The idea, project, model, impact kay jala, tumhi bolu shakta na, tumhi je kay kele tyacha use kay, tyachyamule fayda kay honar aahe, tumhi kasa use karal, dusre kase use kartil, kay farak padla te kelyamule, तुम्हाला काय एक्सपीरियंस मिळाला, जॉय मिळाला का, बर्डन घेतलं, टेंशन घेतलं, असं सांगा ना. आधी मला हे कळतच नव्हतं, काही मी केलं मला जमतच नव्हतं, मग माझ्या एकदम लक्षात आलं. असं बोला, मराठीत बोला, हिंदीत बोला, गुजरातीत बोला, पण बोला, तिथे बोलायला शिका. तुम्ही जे काही दाखवता ना, त्याचा इम्पॅक्ट आला पाहिजे ना ऑडियन्सवर. हा सगळ्यात महत्त्वाचा पॉईंट आहे. तर व्हेरी गुडला 4 आहे, गुडला 3 आहे, त्या ॲव्हरेजला 2 आहे, पुअर लाईक. सो त्याचा इम्पॅक्ट काय आला? तुम्ही किती छान सांगताय, क्रिएटिव्हली सांगताय. एखादा साधा, आपण म्हणतो ना की बोलणाऱ्याचं दगड सुद्धा विकले जातात आणि न बोलणाऱ्याचं आंबे सुद्धा विकले जाणार नाही, तर हा भाग आहे इथे. तर इनोव्हेशन, क्रिएटिव्हिटी काय आणि तुमचं बोलणं काय ते बघा. आणि हे झालं तुमचं ऍक्टिव्हिटी 4 ऍक्टिव्हिटी 6 रुब्रिक बघितलाय का? ऍक्टिव्हिटी 6 सुद्धा कोणी केलेली नाही आहे अजून. एकाची झाली आहे, पण तिथे अपलोडिंग काही नाही आहे, सेफ्टीचं अपलोडिंग नाही आहे. तर सेफ्टीवाल्यांनी अपलोडिंग करायचे. सोमवारी लास्ट तुमचा सेमिनार आहे, लक्षात घ्या. तर हे तुम्ही थोडंसं, मला असं वाटतं, रुब्रिक बघा. ऍक्टिव्हिटी 6 रुब्रिक अपलोड नाही केलेला का? I will see today. Okay, now anything you want to ask me, you can ask.